worship is a word with seven alphabets. The word loses its meaning the moment we remove any one of the alphabets. Worship is a comprehensive approach. It is our natural response to God as the redeemed people of God. We worship because we know His goodness and His loving kindness that endures forever. W stands for work. Rather than you eat or drink or whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 13. Whatever you do, do your work heartily as for the Lord rather than to men. In the King James Version, the emphasis is unto the Lord. And whatsoever you do, do it heartily as to the Lord and not unto men. Colossians 3:23, King James Version. O stands for origami. Origami is Japanese art. As we know it, the early medieval churches were full of art forms, including the painted glass, which was used to ornament windows in churches. This often brings to attention the greatness of God. When viewing some of the awesome work of great artists, especially those which have God as the main theme, we cannot help but to marvel at the greatness of our God. R stands for rest. God intended the Sabbath as a day of rest, where we can spend time in fellowship with Him. When we are in the presence of a greater being like our Lord God, we will naturally worship Him. S stands for silence. We can worship God with singing and dancing. We can worship God in silent meditation. Be still and know that I am God, Psalms 46:1. H stands for healing. God's power and glory is displayed when a healing is done in Jesus' name. Therefore, the very act of healing itself evokes in us the spirit of worship. I stands for illumination. Psalms 119 verse 105 says, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path." Our response to God after reading His word should be the natural sense of awe in who God is. This is worship. Whenever we read the book of Psalms, we are responding to God in worship. P stands for filio, or friendship. Yes, worship can take the form of fellowship among believers. It is also the fellowship that we enjoy in the presence of our God. In fact, Sunday worship is a corporate worship. It is where believers of all walks of life coming together to worship God. Man is created to worship God. Let us go back to the creation story when Adam and Eve were created by God on the sixth day. God's original purpose for man was to enjoy Him to the fullest. He created all the good things in the world for us to enjoy with a heart of gratitude and exalting Him as the creator of all things. Take a moment. Let us worship God together as we watch this short video clip.
It's not that unusual when everything is beautiful. It's just another ordinary miracle today. The sky knows when it's time to snow. Don't need to teach a seed to grow. It's just another ordinary miracle today. Life is like a gift they say, wrapped up for you every day. just work out after all. It's just another